Hello viewers, in this video I am going to discuss about communism. It's also called as Marxism and it is a kind of political philosophy. So let's begin our today's topic on communism. So communism, it's a political theory of system of socialism which gave rise to communism. So had been it is founded by the Marx, Karl Marx. So the Marx also known as the father of communism. So he mostly exiled in Great Britain and France. He wrote the Communist Manifesto. It's a book. In 1848 he served as an inspiration for the formation of Communist Party. So Communist Party example China, USSR. Okay, and communism is also known as Marxism. Let's here we should know about the communism, who invented the communism, Karl Marx, and it's also known as the Marxism. He was called as father of communism. Let's move on to next slide. Here Marxist believed the truly utopian society. So the utopian society having the classes as well as stateless. So the class classes, upper class people and middle class people and lower class people are the labor class people. Here they also don't have the state, so stateless. It should be noted that Marx died well before any of his theories were put to the test. So the theory, he only invented the theory, he does not exist during the practical time. So Marx's main idea was simple. So free the lower class from the poverty and give the poor a fighting chance. So it means reduced poverty. So SDG goal, we are having the goal number 1 as a zero poverty, right? Zero poverty, it is expressed previously by the Marx, and how he believed it should be accomplished however was another story. So in order to liberate the lower class, so liberation of lower class, the Marx believed that the government would have to control all means of production. So he have all means of production. Production control done by the government, then only the lower class people in the liberal society, so that no one could outdo anyone else to make more money. So he told about the haves and have nots. So haves have more money. So due to the control of the government, then the more money accomplished towards one particular classes of the society, it is to be avoided. And unfortunately that proves to be to this day to be more difficult than he might have realized. So it is more difficult than it might have realized. Next, the phases of communism. So here I am going to discuss about three phases. So necessary three phases towards achieving the idea of utopia. Here the first phase is expressed about a revolution must take place in order to overthrow the existing government. So overthrow the government, present government to be overthrown. Here Marx emphasized the need for total destruction of the existing system in order to move on to phase 2. So we first one is exist government to be overthrown. Second, a dictator or the elite leader must gain absolute control over proletariat. Okay, so we will discuss the what is meant by proletariat in the upcoming slides. During this phase, the new government exerts absolute control over the common citizens, person's choice. So the absolute control is done by the leader. So the dictator or the elite leader. Second phase. It's the citizen's personal choices like his or her education, religion, and employment, and even marriage. The collectivization of the property and wealth must also take place. So this is under all the liberal or the citizen choices under the control of one elite leader or the dictator. He emphasized in the second phase. And third kind of phase of the utopian society, in order to achieve utopia, this phase has never been attained because it requires all non-communists to be destroyed. It's not possible. We are not a communist society. So then we cannot destroy by the other persons, right? So that all non-communists to be destroyed in order to achieve the communist party to achieve their supreme equality. So in a Marxist utopia, everyone would happily share property and wealth free from the restrictions that class-based systems require. The government would control all means of the production so that the one class system should remain constant, with no possibility of any middle class citizens rising back to the top. It means there is full control of the government, then no need of accomplishment of the wealth in the upper class society, as well as they are having certain kind of restrictions on the class based system. So this is the third phase. This phase is never going to be accomplished because they want to destroy the non-communist country or the state. Okay, so they need only communist state. It is not possible, right? Next, there are 10 kind of essential tenets of communism, he stated as follows. One is central banking system, government controlled education, government controlled labor, and government ownership of transportation and communication vehicles, government ownership of agricultural means of factories. Till now we discussed only 5 tenets. Here itself you should know that all the system under the control of government. It means the communism mostly focused on the government controlled system. And the sixth point is total abolition of private property and the property rights confiscation. If they are having the property rights, it should be confiscated. And heavy income tax on everyone. Income tax is exposed on everyone. And elimination of rights of inheritance. There is no inheritance power on the property. And final one is regional planning. These all are 10 important tenets of the communism. Okay, let's move on to next slide. Here, there are 4 kind of sections followed the principles of Marxism. So first, the principles for first half was rephrased as manifesto. It means the Marx written the Communist Manifesto, that book in 1848 onwards. That book have the 4 session. One is manifesto first session. Its second half of the rephrased as manifesto second session. And penultimate question answer pair was significantly expanded to become the manifesto's third session, and the final question answer pair was. So penultimate question answer pair is called third manifesto's third session, but in the final question answer pair rephrased as the manifesto's of fourth or the final brief section. So these all are sections followed in the principles of Marxism. So here you should know about there are 4 kind of sections in the principles of Marxism. One is manifesto's first session and second manifesto's second session and third manifesto's third session and final one is manifesto's fourth session are the final brief session. Okay, so let's move on to discuss certain important principles. Only I taken the only important principles only. So let's begin. The topic is what is meant by communism. So communism is the doctrine of the conditions of the liberation of proletariat. So here we should know about it's a doctrine of the conditions of the liberation. So liberation of the proletariat. We should know about which kind of persons are called as the proletariat. So let's start it. What is the proletariat? So proletariat is a class in society which lives entirely from the sale of its labor. So they are accesses sale of its labor and does not draw the profit from any kind of capital, whose weal and woe, whose life and death and whose soul and existence depends on the demand for the labor. So only the labor class society is also called as labor class society also called as proletariat. And hence on the changing the state of business on the vagaries of unbridled competitions, the proletariat or the class of proletarians is in a word the working class of the 19th century. So finally, what is the proletariat? Those who are sell their labor for every day are the hourly basis and they are acts as the working class. Okay, next, proletarians at the then have not always exist. So they are exist or not. So here the existence of the proletarians are not possible. So there have always been poor and working classes, and the working classes mostly been poor. So but there have not always been workers and the poor people living under conditions, and they are today, and other words, they have not always been proletarians. So any more than the there was always been free unbridled competition. So here also the poor people is all currently existing in every world, but they don't have the competition, unbridled competition. So they free from the competition. So that's why they are not existed till now. So how did the proletariat originate? So how the origin of the proletariat? Proletariat originated in the Industrial Revolution, which took place in the England in the last half of the 18th century, and which has since then been repeated in all the civilized countries of the world. So it is repeated in all civilized countries of the world. They are originated in the civilized society, and Industrial Revolution causes the creation of the proletarian groups. Two new classes to be added due to that Industrial Revolution. One is capitalist and another one is the propertyless people. So the class of the big capitalist who in all civilized countries are already in almost exclusive possessions of all means of the subsistence and of the instruments like machines, factories, materials necessary for the production of means of the subsistence. This is the bourgeois class, and they are called bourgeois. And the class of the wholly propertyless who are obliged to sell their labor to the bourgeois in order to get in exchange the means of the subsistence for their support. So this class is also called as the proletarians or the proletarians. Okay, so here the proletarians, what the second class and second one, first one is the capitalist class. Capitalist class having their own possessions and the wealth, etc. But they don't need to subsistence from anyone. But here, the propertyless people, that is the proletarians, and they don't have the property and they need support from the capitalist. Okay, so that is why the two new classes creation. Under what condition does the sale of the labor of the proletarians to the bourgeois take place? So the proletarian don't have the property and they need life in a standard life. They need money for their work and they need to live, so they need food, shelter, etc. So they depend on the bourgeois society. So the labor is a commodity like any other. And it price is therefore determined by the exactly the same laws that apply to other commodities. So in the regime of the big industry, our free competition as well as shall see that the two come to the same thing. The price of the commodity on the average always equal to that of the cost of the production. So the price of the commodity, that is equal to the average production of the particular proletarians. Okay, so hence the price of the labor is equal to that of the cost of the production of the labor. Price of the labor, that is equal to price of the cost of the production. Okay, so here you should know about it, how the conditions of the bourgeois society taking the proletarians for the cost of production. So that is equal to the cost of labor work. So the price of the labor is equal to that of the cost of the production of the labor. Let's move on to next slide here. But the cost of the production of the labor is consist of precisely the quantity means. So cost of production is what? Quantity means. It's not quality based, it's quantity based. So here, the subsistence necessary to enable the worker to continue working and to prevent the working class from dying out. The worker will therefore go no more for this labor than in necessary for this purpose. So the price of the labor or the wage will, other words, be the lowest and minimum and required for the maintenance of their life. So they are going to, the quantity based labor production is given to the labor like in a manner of lowest or the minimum or the only required amount for the maintenance of their life. And however, since the business is sometimes better and sometimes worse, it follows a worker sometimes get more and sometimes they get less for their commodities. So here you learn about the production, how the production means of the labor amount is given. So they are given minimum amount. If the profit is high, then they will give more. But again, just as the industrialist on the average of the good times and bad and gets no more and no less for the commodities than what they cost. So the cost of the production always less than that of the profit, because then only they can earn more. But sometimes it not happen. So the similarly, on the average, the worker gets no more and no less than its minimum. So sometimes they don't getting anything, so they can get only zero amount. And this economic law of the wages operates the more strictly the greater and the degree to which the big industries has taken possessions of all the branches of the production. So it is taken in the all branches of production. But anyhow, what kind of the working classes were there before the Industrial Revolution? Before the IR, okay? After the IR, we know that, what is that? Pro Proletarians, proletarians are there. But before IR, the working classes have always, according to the different stages of the development of the society, lived in the different circumstances and had different relations in owning and ruling classes. In antiquity, the workers were the slaves of the owners, and just as they still are in many backward countries and even in the southern part of the US. So they are mostly stayed in the US certain parts of the backward countries. Okay, next, the Middle Age. So after before the Industrial Revolution, during the Middle Age, where they were the serfs of the land owning nobility. So as they are still in the Hungary, Poland and Russia. So in the Middle Ages, indeed, the right to the Industrial Revolution, there were also journeymen in the cities who worked in the services of petty Pargoyes masters, and gradually, as the manufacture developed, these journeymen became manufacturing workers who were even then employed by larger capitalists. So here one doubt. So first is in the first before the IR, they are in USA, and during the Middle Age, they are in Russia, Hungary and Poland. Now we have a question, because Pargoyes society only, they are exploiting the labor, and labor are the proletarian. So proletarians, it's automatically similar to slave, or they are different from slave? They should different from slaves, because the slaves are the person, those who are taken under the master control. They don't going to get anything. But in the proliferative proletarian society, people, they get certain amount, and they can live their life freely from the Pargoyes society. Okay, so that's why. So till now we discussed about the what is meant by communism. So what are all the principles they are followed, and some sections in the communism, and 10 essential tenets of the communism, as well as certain phases and communism definition, and how the communism is existing in certain society, how it is lead to communist political party in USSR and China, etc. So we discussed till now on the communism. So if you like my video, like it, share it and comment it. Thank you.